Hi, my name is Bintu and today I am going to teach you the difference between C and C++ languages. I won't confuse you by saying that C++ is better than C because it supports OOPs, it supports encapsulation, it supports data heading, whatever. No technical things. I'll just tell you in a very simple way that C supports functions and C++ implements multiple use of functions. Many students contact me asking me, sir, we want to start a career in programming, so what programming languages shall we learn? I usually tell them that please go ahead with C++ followed by Java programming, then Android and so on. Then their usual query is that, sir, before starting with C++, is it necessary to learn with C? My guidance is that you can directly learn with C++ programming. So what is the basic differences between C and C++? The C language supports functions, and the only problem with C is that when you call any function with some values, when you call the same function with some other values, the earlier values are lost. But in C++, because it supports OOPs, the calling of a function with some values will not interfere with the calling of the same function with some other values. How? Let's understand it with this running program. This is a small C program. In this program, I am defining one global integer variable marks. There are two functions, setData and printData. And here is the main function. You are calling the setData function with value 10. This 10 will be assigned to this m integer parameter. From this m, it will be assigned to this global variable marks. So the value of marks will become 10. The control will jump over here again. It will again invoke this setData function with value 20. Again, this 20 will go and assign to m. From this m, it will be assigned to marks. The value of marks will become 20. So what happened to the earlier value 10? Obviously, that value is lost. So that is overwritten. Control will jump over here after updating the marks value. It will come here. It will call printData function. The control will jump here. It will display the value marks are, and the value of marks is 20. So this program will display marks are 20 and the value 10 is lost. But here, it will not happen. Here you can use the same function multiple times without interfering its earlier values. How? Because suppose OOPs. It suppose objects. Now let's understand what is an object. In simple word, an object is a variable of a class. Now what is a class? This is a class. I am calling this class as a student. A class is a collection of certain methods and variables. The functions inside a class are called methods. In this class, student, you can see there are two methods, setData, printData. These are two methods and one variable marks. What these private and public are? These are access modifiers. They define the scope or visibility of this variable. This private modifier is saying that this marks variable is not accessible outside the body of this class. The class gets over here. So if you access marks here in the main function, it will give you an error. But this public access modifier is declaring that these two methods can be accessed outside the body of this class. So let's come here now. As I said, the object is a variable of a class. So these two variables, Ravi and Sanjay, are variables of class student. But technically you can also say that Ravi and Sanjay are objects. Or more precisely, you can say Ravi and Sanjay are instances of class student. So what will happen by that? Ravi will get an entire separate set of these two methods and this variable marks. And Sanjay will also get this copy of this whole set. It also means that the marks value of Ravi will not interfere with the marks value of Sanjay. What you are doing here? You are invoking setData method of Ravi instance. 10 will be passed while invoking setData. This 10 will be assigned to m. From m will be assigned to marks. Which marks? This marks is of Ravi. You are invoking setData method again. This time you are passing 20 value. This 20 will be assigned to m. From m it will be assigned to the marks of Sanjay. The marks of Sanjay will become 20. And what about the marks of Ravi? It is still 10. So that means they are not interfering. This is data heading, or you can say encapsulation. But now you are invoking printData method of Ravi instance. Control will jump over here. Cout is a sort of printer method of C. you're displaying, you're sending the output on the console. What you're sending the output? Marks are, and you're displaying marks value. The marks of Ravi are 10. So the output you'll get, marks are 10. Control will jump here. You are again calling print data method of Sanjay instance. So again the control will come here. It will display marks are, but this time it will display 20. Because the marks of Ravi and Sanjay are not interfered. So this is the beauty of it. Let's run it and see if these programs are displaying the output as such. For running C program, I am using Kigwin. Kigwin provides you a Unix environment in Windows. I have written a program for you. The program is C and cppdiff.c. This is the program that we saw. Let's compile it. It's compiled, no error. Let's run this. See, marks are 20. The 10 are lost. Now let's run the C++ program. I've written the program in dev C++ compiler. This is the program that we discussed. Let's compile it. See, marks are 10. Obviously, these marks are of Ravi. And marks are 20, and these marks are of Sanjay. So you can see that C++ is much better than C, and you can easily understand its program without learning C also. So my personal suggestion is that the students, those who want to make career in programming, they can straight away start with C++ programming without learning C. The C is not required. If you have any question, you can mail me at bmharwani@yahoo.com. Subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.